So I'm here in Excel 2016, and to use Power Query, we can come over to the Data tab where it's being renamed to Get and Transform. Now, if you're using Excel 2010 or Excel 2013, and you have the add-in installed, you're gonna have a different tab up the top here called Power Query. So instead of Data, you'll actually go to a Power Query tab. But here in Excel 2016, I go to Data, Get Data, and you can see here that you have a whole range of different data sources. For this example, where we're going to merge a couple of different tables together, I've got an example set up in a simple text file. So I'm going to come over to text file, and I have a folder sitting here on my desktop called Merging Data. And I'm first going to load in this table employees. You can see that you get a preview of your data here. So you have a few buttons here. We got a load button and an edit button to edit the data before we bring it into Excel. The load button has a little drop down, so we can either load or load to. Load automatically loads our data into a new worksheet. Load to gives us a few additional options. So we can see up the top here that our first option is table. So we have a couple of other options here, pivot table report and pivot chart. These basically allow you to use your data set in a pivot table without actually having to see it inside a sheet. Now, the benefit of this is that your file sizes will actually be much smaller and your calculations will actually run faster as well. So there is actually a benefit to that if you don't actually need to bring all of your data into a sheet inside of Excel. This option over here, only create connection, allows you to create a link to your data so you can refresh that and then use that connection to pull the data into different places within Excel. We have an option down here to add our data to a new worksheet. This little option down the bottom here, add this data to the data model, is actually adding your data to the Power Pivot data model. Power Pivot was an add-in which basically allowed you to process large data sets. I'll leave a link in the lecture resources so that you can see if you have the right copy of Excel to be able to use it. Up here we have where we want to put our data. So we have here new worksheet. And on top of this, we have an option for existing worksheet. So for this example, I'm going to drop all my tables into this one worksheet here, just so that we can see them easily for illustrative purposes only. It's generally not the best idea to add multiple data sets to the same sheet, but these are very small data sets and it's just easier to demonstrate it. So I'm going to drop this into our existing worksheet into cell A1. I'm going to click OK. Our data loads up into this green table over here, and we notice that we have a query and connection over the side here called employees. I'm going to go through this same process again for my second table. So data, get data, from file, from text, and my second table over here is employee data. Again, a very simple table, which I'm going to click load to. And I'm going to drop it into the existing worksheet, and I'm going to stick it right here. Click OK. So here you can see we have two tables of data. And what we want to do is merge these two together. So you notice here that our second table has a couple of extra columns of data. If we wanted to add both of these columns to our first table with a VLOOKUP, you'd have to write two different VLOOKUP formulas, or perhaps a VLOOKUP formula with some sort of match formula within it to look up the column name. To do this instead with Power Query, what we're going to do is we're going to come over to Data again, Get Data, Combine Queries, and we're going to do this Merge. So here we have this screen where we can select our two tables. The first one I have up the top here is employees, and the second table is going to be employee data. What we need to do here is we need to select the column that these two tables are going to join on. So this is like the first column that you would specify for a VLOOKUP. So here I'm going to select employee ID here and employee ID here. Down here, we can see that it's telling us the selection has matched 2 out of the 3 rows. So we can see we have employee IDs 1, 2, and 3 here, and 1, 2, and 4 here. So 1 and 2 are matched against both tables, and 3 and 4 aren't matching. Down here, we have something which is a little bit new if you've only used VLOOKUPs before, but very familiar if you've used databases, which is the join kind. So here we've got a left outer join, also known as just a left join. If we click this dropdown, we can see we have a whole range of options here, from right outer join, full outer join, inner, left anti, and right anti. So I'm going to leave this on left, which is roughly equivalent of a VLOOKUP, and I'm going to click OK. We'll come to this screen here, which is the query editor. And here on our second table, employee data, I can expand this to select the columns that I want to add to the dataset. So here it selected all of the columns for me. I'm going to deselect employee ID since I don't need that to be shown on here twice. And I'm going to click OK. So here we can see we have our extra fields added on to our dataset. And I'm going to load and close these two. Again, we have load or load two. So load two gives you a few additional options like we had before. And I'm going to drop this onto the existing sheet over here so we can see what it looks like. Now, the nice thing about Power Query is that on top of not having to write any formulas, this actually works really fast on larger data sets. And whenever our data gets updated, all we have to do is click the refresh button. And as long as the files are in the same location with the same file names, then these will automatically refresh everything in your sheet. Now, if your source files have changed name or changed locations, you can also update those as well by coming into the query editor for any one of these queries. And we can see here that there's a number of steps. The first step is called source, and we have this little cog here, which allows us to adjust the settings. So here we can basically browse for a new file if that file has changed location. Just cancel out of this. Now I want to show you one of the types of problems that a join solves really well, which is generally pretty hard to do with a VLOOKUP formula. In this example here, we only have one record per employee in our second table. But what happens if we had multiple records? So for example, for one of our employees, let's say we want to pull up their history and see what department they were in for the last 3 years. So I have a data set to illustrate this. So let me come back to data and get from file. And I'm going to load up this file, department history. Now we can see here that in this data set, we only have one employee ID, but it's duplicated 3 times to show 3 different records for this one employee. So they've changed from 2011 to 2013. They've gone through 3 different departments. I'm going to load up this data and I'm going to load it to, and they're going to just drop it on our same sheet again here again. So normally if you were writing a VLOOKUP formula to pull on this data onto our original table up the top here, you would only pull back the first record. If you wanted to pull the other records, that's relatively difficult. However, with Power Query using a left join, that's actually really straightforward and is actually the default behavior. So let's quickly take a look at that now. Again, I'm going to do the same operation as I did before. I'm going to come to data, get data, combine, merge. So my first table, I'm going to set as employees. And the second table, I'm going to set as department history. Again, I'm going to select the employee ID as the field that I'm going to join on. And I'm going to keep this as a left join. And click OK. Let's expand this to add the department and year. I'm going to click OK. And we can see that these fields have been tacked on like so. Notice that the original dataset has actually grown in size now, which is not something that you can do with formulas in Excel, since all of the formulas are linked to a fixed range of cells. I'm going to close and load this to our sheet. Just drop it over here. And that is merging data with Power Query in Excel.